Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. Welcome, Hadith disciples, YouTubers, viewers upon the Sunnah, to another episode to FMF. Today we're in Paris, France. We've done many 5 minutes of faidahs on the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, its virtues, its excellent merits, some of the specific things that you should say and when you should say them, whether it's the tasbih, saying subhanallah, the takbir, saying Allahu Akbar, making a tahleel, saying La ilaha illallah, making a tahmeed, saying Alhamdulillah, and the different ways and styles of saying or making the tahmeed. La hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, seeking Allah's forgiveness. Many fawaid, I believe maybe 3 or 4 we've done before with regards to these different concepts of dhikr. And most of them are on the excellence of dhikr. Now we're going to discuss an issue that many people may have a misunderstanding regarding. And that is, when we hear these hadiths about the virtue of making a statement, he who says this will have his sins forgiven, even if it's like the foam of the sea. He who says this statement will have a house built for him in paradise. He who makes this statement will have, etc. Many people, they may say, how can this be? I make a statement and all of my sins are wiped away. I made something with my tongue, maybe not even focusing with the heart, and Allah will give me this and take away from me that, so on and so forth. Is this a legitimate concern? Is this a legitimate problem? Let's see what one of the ulama of the past, those who explained Sahih Bukhari, what he said about this issue. And this alim here we have with us today is Ibn Battal. May Allah's mercy be upon him. He says here, Al-Hafidh ibn Hajar is quoting him in Fath al-Bari, volume 13. Okay. He says here, قال ابن بطال رحمه الله تعالى هذه الفضائل الواردة في فضل الذكر إنما هي لأهل الشرف في الدين والكمال كالطهارة من الحرام والمعاصي العظام فلا تظن أن من أدمن الذكر وأصر على ما شاءه من شهواته وانتهك دين الله وحرماته أنه يلتحق بالمطهرين المقدسين ويبلغ منازلهم بكلام أجراه على لسانه ليس معه تقوى ولا عمل صالح. Ibn Battal rahimahullah ta'ala, he says, these virtues regarding the excellence of dhikr, he says, إنما هي لأهل الشرف, they only apply to those people of nobility. He says, أهل الشرف, people of nobility. He then says here, في الدين والكمال, people regarding nobility of their religion and their perfection. He then says, such as being clean from haram, being clean from major acts of disobedience, al-ma'asi al-'azam. He says, so no one should think or misunderstand that those who make dhikr and they continually disobey Allah and do whatever they want to do, eat whatever they want to eat, drink whatever they want to drink, fulfill their desires, their lust, however they wish to do so, that all he has to do is make a statement. He has no taqwa, no righteous deeds, and then that's it. He just violates Allah's sacred things. And I said, subhanallah, wa bihamdihi, subhanallah al-azim, or subhanallah al-azim, wa bihamdihi, la ilaha illallah, la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah, 33 times, 30 times, 31 times, 10 times, etc. And then that's it. He says, no, that is not the case. So the concept of these great virtues, it shows us the importance of dhikr. Whereas the intention behind the dhikr is not just to make the statement, but it is to have the concept, the aqidah, the focus of the mind. I'm saying this statement, how can I keep making those other sins, those other mistakes? So this is his view here, and this may not necessarily be absolute. Whereas Allah's virtue and Allah's bounty is wide and expansive, but it's a very important thing for you to think about. When you make dhikr, what type of sins are you making before or afterwards? Does the dhikr put you in a state of remembering? Ask yourself the question. Bidhillahi subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah ar-Rahman subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow all of the hadith disciples and disciples of hadith around the world to be safe. Until the next episode of FMF. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.